Hey, I'm Brennan with Revzilla, and today we're checking out the O'Neill Rider Pro Boots, available at Revzilla.com. So the Rider Pro Boots are gonna be your entry-level trail or MX boot. You've got a microfiber and TPU main construction, and you're looking about 16 inches tall with the overall height of these. Now, before I get going, I did wanna take a second and talk about the overall fit of these boots because it is a little bit tricky. Now, I typically wear a size 10 and a half to a size 11, most of my riding shoes and riding boots. I actually fit perfectly in a size 11 here, but I will note, I measure right at 10.75 inches, you know, with my foot. So I would recommend going with your closest measurement, you know, round up with the measurement that you have. So the closest was an 11 for me because there are no half sizes. So let's say you measure right at 10.2 inches with the overall length of your foot, go with a size 10 and you should be all set. It's not quite a half size between them. So go with your closest measurement and you should be good to go. Now keep in mind, these boots will ship to you for free. And as always, we do have our price match policy in place that is there to ensure that you're getting the best deal around. You're looking at about $140 for these particular boots. Now, if you're looking to step it up, you could check out the Element boots. And if you want to step down in price, you could check out the Rider Shorties as another alternative option. Let's see what we got going on here. We've got a steel cap toe. You can see those three screws there. They're pretty aggressive. That is definitely going to give you some nice protection in the toe area. Excellent crush protection. We can see this TPU that wraps around the toe, working its way to the inside or the medial side of the heel and all the way throughout the boot. You're going to find that excellent crush protection at the heel itself. So that's really nice to have. And then the sole is going to be a stitched rubber sole. So you can see this lug pattern. It's pretty low profile. If anything, I'd love to see this a little bit chunkier just for a little bit extra grip, especially for the guys that are utilizing this as a dual sport or ADV option or just hitting the trails. That'd be nice to have those, you know, just a little bit thicker. But at this price point, I can't be too mad at it. Now, speaking of this price point, you know, I mentioned that this is more of an entry level boot in the MX and kind of the trail world. And the reason for that is because, well, these bend quite a bit. They don't have that same level of torsional and lateral protection that we'd like to see for those more premium level boots. So that's what you're getting, and that's why the price point is around that $140. You're still getting a lot of boot, a lot of good protection here, but it's not gonna be that top tier, you know, torsional and lateral protection that you'll find with the more premium options out there. The buckles themselves, kinda not tricky, I would say, but it's a two-stage system here. So I'm pulling this buckle out. And what this does, this is gonna slot in. You can kind of hear the click. You can hear that click into place. And then as you close that, that's what's gonna lock it down. So it's kind of a two-stage system there. These are adjustable, all four of these buckles. So you can fine tune that. You can see you've got a little bit of brush protection here as well. If you're getting rocks or branches or anything like that, should skate right over that and skip that buckle. I'd love to see, you know, more of that incorporated on the other buckles. I'd love to see that with other manufacturers. They usually only give us the one down here towards the bottom. But let's go ahead and open this bad boy up. Take a look on the inside here. Got to wrestle those off a little bit. A little bit of Velcro towards the top as we work our way onto the inside. Very straightforward, just a light mesh interior there just to help with the overall circulation and the airflow, but otherwise very straightforward. Now you're looking out at about a 10 out of 10 when it comes to the overall stiffness of the sole itself. But as I mentioned before, you're not getting that same level of torsional and lateral protection that you're often gonna find with more premium options. Oh boy, I'm gonna get these bad boys back into place. And that is why it's really a two-stage system here. So you gotta lock this in, you'll kinda hear that click, and then close it shut. So once you do it a few times, it'll become muscle memory. You won't really think about it anymore, but at this angle too, it makes it a little bit more challenging as well. Swinging over to the medial side, you can see this, this gripper material here towards the top, and this is gonna help prevent that premature wear in this area as you're hugging the frame of your bike. But I think for an entry-level dual sport kind of trail riding boot, these are gonna be an excellent option for a lot of riders out there. Just again, don't forget, you know, you are sacrificing a little bit of that torsional and lateral protection as I mentioned before. Of course, if you're looking for more details, click that info button on your desktop or mobile device. That's gonna take you over to Revzilla.com. You can read other rider reviews and see what other people are saying about these particular boots as they're putting them through their paces. And of course, if you have any additional questions for us, please don't hesitate to reach out. Give our Gear Geeks a call at 877-792-9455 or simply shoot over an email cs@revzilla.com. Thanks for hanging out with us for a bit, taking a closer look at the O'Neill Rider Pro Boots. I'm Brandon, keep it pinned.